Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to PhotoBiz Live. This is Andy from the PhotoBiz team. Today we are joined by Richard Sturdevant of Sturdevant Studios for a webinar about high-volume school sports composites and products. When photographing volume, it's all about the average sale and how you can increase that average. In this webinar, Richard will show you what he has done to offer high-quality sports composite art, posters, and large banners that are designed and produced quickly. In addition to getting the opportunity to learn from Richard in today's webinar, we will also have a question and answer session at the end of the webinar. You may submit your questions using the chat tool, and they will be answered after the presentation. You can also join in the discussion on Twitter by using the hashtag PhotoBizLive. If at any point during today's webinar you have difficulty hearing the speaker or seeing the slides, please use the comment box to let us know. We will be recording this webinar, and it will be available for replay on our YouTube channel at youtube.com/photobiz. With that being said, I'll turn things over to Richard.
Hey, thank you very much. Thanks for coming on today. Hopefully we'll have a really good time here, no computer issues. I'm going to go ahead and switch over to Keynote now. Everything looks good so far. We're going to talk about sports art and, you know, high volume teams and individual packages, which I do a lot of out of my studio. Even though I do the really high-end type of images, I really make a lot of money doing this. It is really brings a lot of money into my studio. So I'm going to go ahead and move over to the next slide. And my studio is Sturdevant Studio. I have a storefront, and we actually service four high schools. And so out of that, you know, I also have Sturdevant Art Tools, which I'll tell you about a little bit later. But we specialize in, you know, being known for something different. And we want to be the best at what we do in our area. And there's a lot of competition today, and there's a lot of, you know, people that have really raised their game as far as art and in their business. And it's very important that you really are known in the community for doing something that is really different. We like to turn ordinary into the extraordinary. And basically, what is my business and what do I do? I own a full, like I said, a full portrait commercial studio, storefront. And I photograph high school seniors, school sports teams, families, weddings, sporting events, commercial assignments, full graphic design studio. And we also create fine art. And my graphic background as an artist and a graphic designer really comes into play when I'm actually doing my sports images, because everybody, you know, they kind of can get to the same level almost with you know, the quality of photography. So it comes into design whether it can separate your studio from the other. What makes me different, as I said earlier, I'm an artist and I'm known for composites. Everybody in my area knows me for my composite ability, and I'll just show you a kind of a sample of two different styles that I may do. One on the left is a, you know, super fantastic, you know, something I may do for a commercial client, even for competition, and, you know, it almost looks like a movie poster. And so when my seniors or my athletes come into the studio, or we promote this when we go out and shoot, we also have banners and everything up so they can see the other type of work that we do, they get really excited about that because they think, well, man, if he can do that, he can do anything we want. On the right, you know, you have more of a team sports composite that we actually did a couple years ago for one of our high schools. And the Hawks and the Jackets actually play each other every year. It's a big deal in the school. It's like 3,000 people in the stands. It's absolutely nuts. And this game was so close, as you can see by the score, we really wanted to do something special for that school that won. It was right down to the last, you know, few seconds of the game. And all these moments that I photographed, you know, photographing on the sideline, were every one of those were key moments that every one of those people that were there remember. And we put this together and did a big canvas for the coach. And, you know, it went over so well, we printed one for each player. And then we started selling them to people in the community. Just started getting phone calls one after other. And that, you just can't pay for that kind of advertisement, that word of mouth. I'm going to show you, you know, just some regular little stuff that we do where we make our package money. And, you know, we may sell a package for like $105 and, you know, it may be something like this, and they may, you know, buy you know, 8x10s and buttons and cutouts, you know, whatever your sports package may be. But $105, you know, I want to get that average up. So I also add sports art posters in our design. And they can sell anywhere from $35 to $125, depending on the school and what quality that we put into. But I will actually go in there and just take a normal image that I shoot at the gym. Sometimes we'll shoot against white or gray to take out the backgrounds. But we just go in and take out that background, and there's the image by itself. So remove that, remove the gym. And then we come back and place a grunge texture in the background, just kind of a wall, just with the same kind of perspective as the gym had. Then I'll come in and add some shadows and reflections. And what I actually did here was I actually used the reflection on the floor that was already existing in the original photo right there. And so I just desaturated and blended it into the background. Now, once I did that, I went in and started adding other textures. And I just started slowly building that up. And this is just for one team. And then we just went in and put the logo in the back, added some Color Effects Pro, added more of an illustrated look to it, and did our final finish to it and really made it complete. And then we sell this for like $75, this particular poster. Now, I only do it one time, and all I have to do is drop each player in. And so I've already got the work done in the beginning. And they just love this kind of stuff. And I'm going to show you, then you can go and do something extreme, like this particular image right here. We had some displays of some other art, and so they wanted something where, you know, it looks like he was burning up the sand in the desert, flames behind him. It's crazy, but these kids love it. And, just little things like this, like I'll make my backgrounds, and I already have pre-made backgrounds that I can do stuff while we're on the shoot. You know, we'll also do some action shots while we're doing the actual individuals, and I can take that and do this kind of stuff with it, with backgrounds that I already have made up. Or you can purchase backgrounds from a number of sources. This here was also, this is like a dancer image, and this was actually a demo at one of our Texas school classes, and but we do a lot of dancers as well. And so, you know, a lot of people associate sports with football, baseball, basketball, but dance is really, really huge, and there's a lot of money in dance. And so this is Cassie Armendariz, which is one of my former seniors, and she's actually a Mavericks dancer for the Dallas Mavericks now. But as you can see, she came in and posed for us at Texas school, and she's pretty athletic. And so I wanted to do something different with that. As you can see, the image on the bottom left, you know, it's just against a white backdrop, just kind of going gray. And then we added all these other elements in there and created this motion. And I thought it was really turned out to be a really nice piece. And here's a close-up of it so you can see a little bit more of the detail. Now, this type of image would cost a little bit more, you know, than $75 or $125, because there's a little bit more work done into it. But you can take these same elements and go ahead and build this PSD file to where you can actually drop girls in one right after the other, and do a finish on it, and boom, you can mass produce this very quickly. Here's one that we did for a promotion for my son's school. He's a senior this year at Sachse, and which this image got me a lot of business from all four of my schools. We took this background. It was from ImageScapes, Jim Cunningham's backgrounds, and I took it and changed it around, put a new sky, put a crowd in it, put lights in there, and then photographed him holding the football, and evidently he's fireproof. But I wanted to do something different, something that had impact, and this is what gets you attention. And there's so many photographers out there doing so many great things, so many great ideas. It's really a challenge to do new stuff, so I just keep pushing and pushing and pushing. And as long as I can keep myself in the minds of people out there, they're going to come use me. And here's another image that was what we did for a promotion this year called our sports art poster, which didn't have graphics on it. It was just something that was a sports image that the parents could buy out of the package, and they could actually frame this, and it would look like a fine art, but as a sports image in their house. And and we sold quite a few of these. It went over really well. I was really excited and happy with the turnout that we had as far as this goes. And I just developed the, you know, the file, created the background, and was just able to drop in using clipping mask, and then did a final finishing technique over it, in which I'll show in just a few minutes. And it made it look really complete, and I can mass produce these, you know, I can do one like every 10 minutes. Same type of technique that here, more of a commercial image that we did for, you know, After Dark. You know, we put, she was just wearing regular tights, and we put some texture over that. And I could do that same texture with a clipping mask and do it on light poses for different, you know, individuals that we photographed that day. And so every year, you know, we're thinking about something different. And this year, you know, I'm already thinking about next year, what we're going to do then. Art, fine art, you know, as far as compositing. This right here would cost, you know, a lot more money because it's painted. But as you can see, the images that you see there that are action shots that were taken at the game, I combined to one referee and the other shot and just, you know, took a little artistic license. But once I put this out there, clients started seeing it. So they would go online, see the action shots, and they're, oh, I want this one and that one. Can you do this? And they'll call me for a quote. And, you know, if you if they want it bad enough, they're going to figure a way to pay for it. And so this particular image, we did a promotion for like $650 to this particular school. And we sold about 10 out of that. So, you know, that really added to that school's sales for football that year. Here's another image, and we did this the previous year, and you know, different action shots, and with the same tonality for the Rockwell Yellow Jackets, and this went over very well, and I think I actually used this in competition, and I used the one before that in competition as well for, like, PPA. Now, here's this year. That original poster that you saw, the sports art poster I did on my son with number 44, that was the pose that I decided to use for all of my what we call storefront posters that we use for the high schools. And how this works is we actually sell storefront posters to the entire team. So let's say you have 55, 60 players. Each one of those players would get a poster at a discounted rate. And the booster club would buy those, and from there they would hang those around town to promote the kids, you know, give them a little bit of recognition, and also promote the team and promote spirit for people coming to the games. And they always, this is also in the order form, they always, almost always buy another poster. We have two different sizes that we sell at this one. It's 12 by 18. And a 16 by 24. The 16 by 24 we just started adding this year, and one school decided to go with it, and the other school decided to stay with the 12 by 18. So, you know, as long as you give them opportunities and choices, they're going to love to have this kind of stuff. As a result, this year, we decided to start doing banners, and if you go on my Facebook page, you'll search through there, you can see some of these banners all displayed along some of the games that I'm shooting on Friday and Thursday nights. But the banners were absolutely beautiful, and I got so much recognition for that. I've got, just last week at the game, I had somebody from the school district, of the Garland School District, come and ask me if they could talk to me about doing some work for them, just because they've seen the banners. Everything you do can lead to something else. This is one for the Rockwall, you know, and I like to keep them different. I don't want to do the same, maybe the same pose, but I want to keep a different design. And most of my skill comes in, you know, designing the image. And once I design it, you know, I can do it for all 60 players. And then, you know, people say, well, where do you get your ideas from? Because a lot of times people say, I have trouble coming up with ideas. I have to go and look at other people's work. And, you know, we all should be inspired by other people's work, but, you know, you can go to the movies, you know, music videos, and anything can lead to a new idea. You know, look at designs online and, you know, graphic designs, and see what they, how they use things, how they use swooshes, you know, how they use different graphics, and just go in there and start playing. here's some of my more extravagant work that you might see, you know, in my studio or that I've done for commercial clients in the past and toy manufacturers. And this is pretty crazy. When my clients see this, they're just in awe. And I'm just going to show you a few of these real quick. And there's a detail shot of that. And our, you know, real steel here. Actually took these action figures and photographed them. This is actually my son jumping up there and my buddy in the background. And, you know, it was a lot of fun. And this did very well for me. A lot of different avenues. Here's a close-up of it. And that's 6-inch action figures. So that was a lot of fun. Self-portrait that I used to promote myself. You know, I could stick a normal self-portrait up there, but I want people to know I'm different. I got a creative mind, and I want my schools to know it. I don't want to be known as just a school photographer, and thankfully I'm not in my area. Posters. You know, one of the best poster designers out there, artist, in my opinion, has been Shirk. He's above all of us on that, and he does really, really incredible creative stuff. My clients, they know I can do that creative stuff, but they want to keep it more simple. So we decide to give them, you know, what they want. We do this a couple different ways. You know, either they'll give me full creative freedom, or they'll come in with an idea, or they have certain things that they may want in the poster, and then I have to design around that. And you know, I get a lot of emails from people saying, "Well, how do you sell these things?" And I'm gonna show you real quick just a couple of them. And this is also one for the Yellow Jackets, which is more, it was actually used for a football cover and to promote that football season that year. And here's a close-up of it. And as you can see, when people see this hanging around town, it's, you know, it's pretty incredible that they see the detail that goes into it. And I think that's important that, you know, they don't see flaws in the product. Poster I guess strictly business. You know, they had their idea of their one to wear their bow ties, and you know, they went to state last year for the Rockwell Yellow Jacket baseball. And so here's how we work this. We do 18 by 24 posters, and these posters have to be at least 300 because we do offset printing, and that can range, you know, I mean, people want to say, well, we need 100 posters. Well, it's going to cost you the same as 300. So what we do is we charge a flat fee of $1,200. Now, how do we make that work? Because I hear people all the time saying, I can't get people to buy them because they don't have any money. The schools don't have any money. Well, this is where we show them how to get sponsorship, where they can go out to different businesses. This particular poster has one sponsor. Some teams, they have enough in their budget, they don't need a sponsor. Some of them need like 6 sponsors. Let me see if I got that one doesn't have a sponsor. And that one doesn't have a sponsor. Let me see if I can go back. But in any case, sometimes they'll have like 6-7 sponsors down there that'll pay like $150, $200 so that they can get these posters done. And I always feel like that I need to charge for this and I need to make money off of it. It costs me about $300 to get them printed. So the rest of that, you know, $900 is for the photography, for the design work, and that pays for my time. But here's the key. It hangs around town, and by you forcing them to get 300 posters, they'll hang them everywhere. And if they're hanging all through the city, your logo is being seen. And I have got more business from different things, from realtors, from banks, from the school district, from Chamber of Commerce. All when they see my name on there, they give me a call and say, we're interested in doing this. Can you do this? And obviously, I'm going to say, yes, I can do anything. And so that's how we promote those posters. We got one team that buys 500, and that's our Rockwell girls basketball, who has went to state a couple times. And so they have a day where they go out and they train little kids, and they do a poster signing party. And I see all kinds of people on Facebook that are doing so many different types of promotion. It's just incredible what you can do with this stuff. These are the individual posters of each cheerleader that are hanging around town. That is 16 by 24. We put those all together and also did a team shot to where it's just real clean. And this is the actual shot, the post 18 by 24 poster. So not only do they have those individual 16 by 24 posters, they have an 18 by 24 poster of the team that they can put out as well. Now, this is one I use a Ben Shirk template on it, and he laughed at me, of course, but he did a great job, and man, I bought the template and I used it, and they're, you know, I'm not beyond using other photographers' work if I need to for my business, and so he sold it, I bought it, and I made money off of it, and you should too. This is other stuff that we do for the school, like we do a cabaret show every year for our cheerleaders, which I consider sports, and we'll design different types of posters for them for their cabaret show, and we bring them in the studio and they pose, and it's a lot of fun. This is our girls basketball team that has gone to state, and again, they've been doing posters with me as well as the boys basketball for like almost 10 years now. And I'm just going to go through this couple little shots, and I'm going to stop right there, and I'm going to talk to you a little bit about some options on those posters. And what you can do with those is some people actually do them for free. I know I got several friends that actually, photographers that actually promote it as a free benefit so that they get all the senior images, senior clients through, promoting that. And, it just depends on what area you're in and what works for you. I tend to think that if I give it away, I devalue the work. They don't want to pay for the other stuff I want to sell. So I'm very careful not to give it away. But in some cases, it works really well. So, you might have to kind of play around and see what works for you in your area. Well, I'm going to escape out of this and go ahead and move this over here. And we're going to go to Photoshop real quick. And I just wanted to pull this image up because this is a I did this as a demo at Texas school. And as a result, we started doing MMA fighters for local gyms around town. And, they see this and they're like, wow. And as you can see, down at the bottom, it's just shot against gray. And then, I used a background from Jim Cunningham, which, as you can see, is pretty high key there compared to what I did with it. Used a stock photography on the bag. And then also put a rat in here, chain. Got some bags and Everlast. You got to have an Everlast bag in there, and I put this all together. And also have a video on this that shows the total breakdown and goes step by step with this thing. It's pretty incredible. All the layers. There's quite a few layers in there. But this type of work right here will get you noticed. We had this on display when we shot football, and all the kids kept looking at it. We had it on a roll up, and they just kept talking about it. Also, I had one with a basketball player. And they just kept looking at it, and they're like, oh, my God, it's awesome. I want something like that. Now, also banners. So I know I'm going fast here. We've got a lot of content to get into. The banners went over like wildfire this year. I mean, I'm just really, really happy with it. And so what we do is we basically sell these for $95 a piece for an individual. If the team buys them, we can get those down to like $60. $65 a banner, and that's a 3-foot by 5-foot banner, and it'll approximately cost us about anywhere from $22 to $25 to get these produced, and the color is actually phenomenal. But you can put your logo on there, and have them displayed at the games. Plus, they always usually announce your name at the games, like Sturdevant Studios for such and such. Even though they pay for them, they got a discount for that. And it actually increases my average for my sales. And I may go out and shoot a school one day that has like, maybe 300 kids in it. And, you can make anywhere from, $6,000, $10,000, $15,000 on just, one school. And for the whole school year, you can make up like the $30,000 on that, one school. Sometimes even more if you're doing more of the school pictures instead of the sports. But I like to focus more on the sports because that's what I'm into. But this banner here was a 4-foot by 6-foot banner, and we actually donated this one to the coach, which they use at the games, and also, they display it at the field house as well. So let's go ahead and look at what you're really here to see is the sports posters and banners. And so I try to design them where I can use the same design for the sports poster, which might be 12 by 18 or 16 by 24, but I use it to where I can also make a banner out of that. And this is one of our star quarterback for Sexy Mustangs. His name's Kent Myers, really great Christian, and just super kid. And this kid has no quit in him. He's a great player. But anyways, we want to focus on the seniors on these banners. And so I put the design together, and this is what the final looks like. And it's just a takeoff of what we did on the earlier image that you saw of the Sexy. So I'm going to turn that off, and I'm going to show you the background. And this was the background that I kind of pre-designed that I used for my son's image, number 44. And so I've went ahead and put it in the background here. Obviously, it wasn't, you know, long enough for this particular format. So I put a layer mask on it and just painted away, let it fade it off, and it just kind of faded off into nothing. And then I come in here and I turn on the next layer, and I got this texture offline, which is just metal texture. And I kind of just put it in the background so that it actually fades into this background. Now, I had the swoosh that I had that I used on almost everything this year, which I could make it look different each time. It's really cool. And if I turn this on, and let me turn this layer off here, turn it off, and I'll go put that on normal. And that's what that swoosh looks like. And so I can move it around, you know, and change the color, whatever I want to do with it. So I'm going to take that first one, and I'm just going to put it in screen mode. And blending modes here are very important when you're doing design work, because you can really slowly build up a beautiful design, allowing some of that texture from the bottom to come through. And, you know, I really wanted to play on these lights and that stadium in the background, really have this faded off. Now I'll turn this next one on. And I've got it. It's just a duplicate, 100% it's screen. And then I turn the third one on, and it is in soft light mode. So you can see that it actually really oversaturated everything and made it look really, really vibrant and beautiful. And I have a layer mask on it that I could turn on and off. And see right there, I had to paint away so those lights could come through. And then I put a actual layer mask on the whole folder. I actually put them in a folder and closed that folder. And I'm going to turn that layer mask off, and that's what it looked like. And say, so I just painted away that top, you know, and everybody has different, you know, tastes. So you might want to left more of that swoosh on there. I decided to take it off, though. Now, let me turn that, let me show you what that mask looks like. So I just painted all this away, just leaving this bottom part here. I'm going to turn that back. Now I wanted to go in and add their Sexy S, which they have a special S, and I like to go in and kind of redesign it, give it some, you know, beveled edges and make it look like it's glossy. So I turn this on, and I have that in screen. Let me go ahead and turn it on normal mode, and I'll take it up to 100%. And that's basically, turn that off, that's what it looked like right there. And so I can turn that mask back on and go to screen mode. And go back down to 69%. All right. And then I'll turn this, make a duplicate layer. I like to use screen mode, soft light mode, to really build these things up slowly so they don't block up, your shadows don't block up, and you have lots of vibrant color. And so I turn that back on. Now, you see how much richer that got? And that one's in soft light, but I did it over the screen mode. And it just blends in, and it really makes that really beautiful blue through there. And I can close that folder, and here's the mask that I put on it, just painting away the bottom part so that it kind of faded off. Now we're going to take the Kent's image and place him in here. And I'm going to turn his mask off for a second. And that's just dropping him in, taking out the background. And you can go to my website, sturdevinci.com. And there's a video on there that you can download for free that'll teach you how to take out the backgrounds with Photoshop. I think that one's like Photoshop CS5, but it'll work in CS6 or CC. So I just take this, and I want to fade out because I don't want any attention brought to this down here, and I don't want any competition with the graphics that I'm going to put with the name down here. So I just put a little layer mask on it and just kind of fade it off using a smoke brush to kind of paint that away. And if I turn that, show you what the mask looks like, as you can see, I just used the smoke brush to kind of paint it to where it just faded off. It looked like a little bit of smoke. So then I turn that back on. Then I put a black gradient down there just to darken everything up a little bit. And then I come in here and add some smoke, like some orange smoke. And I just did that on the layer just with a smoke brush and just kind of painted on there. And I think I got that in normal mode. I didn't have to do a lot because it did just what I needed to do. And now I start adding more graphics into this and to make sure that I can get all the content. It doesn't look crowded and it looks like it flows with the image. So this year I went with this theme of putting this bar across the bottom. And when I started posting this on Facebook, I started noticing a lot of people doing this, and it's really cool, because it just looks clean. And I think with design, you want everything to look clean. And if these parents love it and the kids love it, they're going to buy it. Now I'll take Sexy Mustangs. And what I did here is I made two copies, but I did one in orange and one in white. And just so that I could get this little white outline around that, because I did this with strokes and beveled the edges. And so if I come over here and I turn that off, that's what it looks like. So I just put these effects. And if you've ever played with styles, your styles are up here. And you can go through there and you can click on those and it'll apply it to that text. And you can do all kinds of things with that. And I've got so many styles. Half of them I've made myself. Plus I've downloaded some, I've got some from other photographers, other artists. You're going to develop your collection and you'll have your ones that are really your favorites. You can do chrome lettering with styles. It's just really pretty cool. So I'm going to turn that, turn those back on. Now I got my Sexy Mustangs. I'm going to add a 2014, put that right up there. That year they graduates big. If you don't put it on there, the parents, they don't like that. Now I'm going to put the name, Kent Myers, and leave that in white. And here's the outer glow that I put on it that was black just so that I can make it stand out against that background. And then I go over here and put Senior, which I did a little script. And I just I went ahead and put it over the 2014 because I didn't want to keep stacking on top of this and, building a pyramid. I just wanted to have a, Senior 2014 is easy enough to see. And then we got the final image here. Now, I'm going to turn this on here. Now, here's another thing that we can do that you can actually finish these posters off with is I made a copy, and I'll turn this off. We'll do it again. You can make a copy of this and leave it in layers so that, you don't flatten it, and you can use it for other players as well. Is you go hit Shift, Option, Command, E, and again, I'll repeat that. And let me delete that. We'll do it again. Shift, Option, Command, E. And what that'll do is a merge visible. It'll merge your document. So I'm going to take this, and I'm going to use an action that I have called Sturdevant 1, and I'm going to play it and show you what it does. Blah, blah, blah. The background's not available. Just hit continue. And what it's going to do is it's going to make a couple of copies of this thing. And one of them is going to kind of soften it. And the other one's going to saturate it a little bit. And so I've got this, I'll turn that one off. I've got this one I turn on, and let me zoom in here. And it just kind of softens everything. It kind of helps blend all these little edges that you may have. You can also put a mask on there, click on this, and you can paint away. You can paint away like the real important places, eyes, mouth. Let's see if I can get that. There we go. And then I turn this next layer on, which is in a soft light, which is a blurred layer, Gaussian blur, and it's just put in soft light, and I brought it down to 41%. And as you can see, it really kind of makes everything just kind of pull together. The only thing about that is it can, block up some areas. So if you have some areas that are blocked up in your shadows, you can come over here and paint away in those shadows. the hair and bring some of that detail back. And, oh, there we go. You know, some of it down through there. Maybe make the brush a little bigger. There. And then we can also kind of highlight, we'll highlight the legs there a little bit. Now, you wouldn't have to do this on every poster, but if they're paying, you know, $75, you know, you might want to do that. And $75, $125, that may not sound like a lot of money, but when you've got, you know, at least 30, 40% of 60 players buying those, it adds up to a lot of money really fast. Now, we can start asking some questions and kind of talk a little bit more about the posters and pricing, and go ahead and take it from here.
All right. Thank you for that presentation, Richard. So now the floor is going to be open for questions. There's a questions box just in the webinar software. First question pops up. Where can we get backgrounds?
Well, can you still hear me?
I can still hear you.
Okay. There's several different places you can get them from. You can go to my site, sturdevinci.com. You can go to ImageScapes with the, I don't know what the website is, but that's my friend Jim Cunningham has a lot of beautiful backgrounds. Also, there's Mark Bryant that has some backgrounds out there. And if you get online, you can find, just do a search for sports art backgrounds. You'll find quite a few. But you're more than welcome to come to sturdevinci.com.
Okay, got another question from Jim. Do you get the posters printed at your color lab?
No, not all the time. I have a printer that I print a lot of my posters when I have a lot of volume. But if we're too busy, we send those out to the BWC to do that on the posters. And they, you know, you do it on the volume rows pricing, and the price is really, really affordable. So I think the maximum that I think it's probably like $10 for 16 by 24. You know, but if I can, if I have a lot of them and I can do them, I can produce it pretty cheap. So, but BWC does all the package pricing, meaning package orders and everything from that.
All right. This question comes from Gary. How different is the process when not working with skin tones, cars or aircraft, for instance?
You know, it is exactly the same. There's really no difference because, you know, if you look at this image, the skin tones pretty much go with everything else in here. And I'm not just looking at the skin tones to be important. I'm looking at the whole image. So especially this process that I showed would work really well. And, you know, I've done calendars for auto clubs, and I just did a custom poster for a car club that has a big event, and that was a lot of fun. It was really cool.
Okay, another question from Renee. What's the best way, in your opinion, to break into the high school market?
Well, I hear this a lot, and it's tough, but here's my recipe for it. Get involved with the booster club in the school, and it's as much as I hate to say this, it is a political game. It's not always the best or most talented person that may get the job if you bid on it. A lot of times it has, you know, what the pricing is, what you're given, and school contracts. You need to get some experience at dealing with schools, and Ralph Romagara. You know, Romagara Studios, you know, who's PPA president right now, has a book that he sells that teaches you, you know, how to get in and do that type of work. But the main thing is do good work and produce it and get it around. And sometimes, you know, if you're starting out, you may have to go in and get a little lower price. I hate to say that, but sometimes it's best to do that just so you can get your work seen. Because if you got really magnificent work and it can be seen, you're going to get notoriety very quickly. If it's, you know, middle of the road work, you know, you're going to have to promote more, you know, or get your skills up better. But you know, when it comes down to actually getting in there and getting the work, as the images are going to be pretty standard that you're going to get. So you know, you're probably not going to be that much better than the next photographer, because all the schools want the same type of work. But that's where you have to go in and say, I want to try something different. I did something one year where I had a lot of dramatic lighting, and I got complaints because there's too many shadows on the face. So I had to watch that. I got to make sure the faces are really lit up. But as far as the schools, also try to develop a relationship with coaches if you can get in to see them.
Okay. I got a good follow-up on that one. Do you find that you have to give kickbacks to the high school?
Well, it used to be that way all the time. I mean, you would, and with the big school contracts, there is kickbacks. They claim they're not, but they are. But the way that I do kickbacks now is that I help them with graphic design. And that's the way I based my whole business on. Instead of me giving you cash back, I'm going to give you my talent. Because if I can give you my talent, then that's going to get my work out there even more. It's going to get me even more exposure, even more notoriety, and it's going to bring more potential for me making more money. And so that's been very successful for me. But everybody's different, and every area is different, you know, and each individual you're dealing with, whether it be a coach or a school or a parent of a booster club, you know, each time it's going to be different. So anybody that tells you, if you do this, this will work, it's not always going to work. It's, you know, you have to be able to adapt. And best is go by your instincts.
Okay, I have a two-parter here from Danny. He asks, are most of the player shots done in studio? And if they are, is it a three-light setup?
It is a three-light setup. And I use six-foot strip boxes. Or you can, you know, that's just what I use. You could use a three-foot, four-foot strip boxes with grids. And then I use a light overhead. Now that could be a starfish, it could be an octobox. I like using the light shaper or light bender with Larson that Larry Peters designed for them. I just love how it works, and I also use an eye lighter with that as well. So it really lights up the subject, gives me some good directional lighting, but everything's really well lit up, and that's what we did here with Kent, as you see on the screen.
Okay, this one's from Daniel. How much time do you normally spend creating the original backgrounds that you build off of?
You know, it could be, you know, I could do some sometimes in 10 or 15 minutes. Sometimes it may take an hour. You know, on rare occasion for this type of work, you know, I may spend a couple hours on it. But here's the beautiful thing about that. It doesn't matter whether you spend 15 minutes or you spend 2 hours. Once you get it done and you have it in layers and you have it set up in a template to where you can just drop people in, you're printing money from that point on.
Okay, I got a question from Fuller. Have you tried the style with high school bands, JROTCs, or any of the other non-sports related?
Oh, absolutely. I look at them. When I say sports, I'm talking about all school extracurricular activities, whether it could be drama, choir, we do band, you know, we do gymnastics. It's not just sports. And I'm very good about adapting to what they do, you know, and we're doing some stuff for the drama club. I do cross country tomorrow. Tomorrow morning we'll actually do a poster for them. But yes, I mean, everybody, in fact, a lot of times you can make more money through the band or through one of those, through like a choir, than you can with sports sometimes, because they don't get that all the time. They don't get the cool stuff. It's always the football team or the baseball team that gets this cool stuff. So if you could really bring some attention to them and get them some notoriety, they're going to love you.
Okay, another one from Renee. What's the best Photoshop masking method you use, and does it matter if you use a neutral background?
You know, everybody's different. I mean, there's really no right answer. I mean, for me personally, I'll use a neutral background, like it's basically white, and you know, I have just enough light hitting it that you know, it doesn't go dark, but it goes to about an 18% gray on most days. And that seems to work well because I can see my lights and I can see my darks. A lot of people use green screen, and in fact, Ben Shirk is doing something with the action with green screen, and I'm going to be trying it out. But I don't like green screen because I have a small studio, and I can't get enough distance between my subject and my background in my studio, or when I go on a location, because I get too much of that green spill. And people say, oh, I don't get that. You get it. It's just you have to go in and take care of it. So it just, you know, it just depends on what is more comfortable for you.
All right. Oh, there we go. do you personally post any Photoshop tutorials on YouTube?
I have some, yes. There, you can get those through my Sturdevant. I think it's on YouTube and Vimeo. Sturdevant.com. I have a few on there. And then there's some floating around out there from different speaking events and stuff. But we also have, I sell how-to tutorials and DVDs on my website, and we've also got some new ones coming out. And so you could go there and, you know, just keep checking back at the website at sturdevinci.com.
All right. Any last questions? Okay. This one's from Christina. Do you go to the school or do the students come to your studio?
Both. For the bigger teams, we go to the school. Like for the football teams, we'll go, and we've always, for years, we shot outside. And so I talked the coaches and to my three of my high schools to shoot in the gym. They weren't too keen on it at first, but I showed them what I could do in the gym. And what we do is we set two setups. We usually have a printed background that has like a stadium or something, or maybe use the gym. They have like a mural in the gym that we'll use, and we'll light it really good. All the key is in lighting it to make the image look great, you know, so that they love it. But we'll have one station for the package shot, which is 8x10s, 5x7s, and then we'll take them over to a white backdrop in which we do this type of shot here. Now, on other occasions, the smaller teams will come to my studio, and we have to have so many players, or we'll charge them a session fee to go out there. But because the only way that we make money is if they buy, you know, they just don't buy this outright. So we try to, you know, promote as much as we can for them to come to the studio if possible in the smaller teams.
Okay, kind of follow up to that. When you do shoot your school events, how long do you spend per athlete?
Oh, it's fast. I mean, we do two shots per athlete on the package shots and two shots on the white backdrop. And when I say white, it goes gray. But the key to dealing with football coaches is you've got to be fast as lightning. I mean, they do not like pictures. They don't want to be there, and they're trying to be as nice as they can, but at that moment, they really don't care for you. They just want to get back to practice. And so you have to be fast, and you have to take charge when you go in there. And I take total charge in there, and I instruct the boys on what to do and how to pose, and this is what we're going to do. We do the team shot, you know, don't disrespect your town, your school, or your teammates by making faces. And, you know, you have to deal with them like the coaches deal with them in those situations. And if the coaches can see you're taking authority and you're doing it quick, then they're going to love you. And it's going to, but if you take all day and the coaches is like, he's like, man, this guy's driving me nuts. You're not going to be there long.
Okay. Kind of a new tack here from Daniel. Can you use more than one portrait of the same student to create a montage feel? And if you've done that, do you have any suggestions?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. There's a PPA article that I wrote a couple years ago. You can go search on PPA.com for the archive, which has a sports composite, which I use images, just normal images plus action shots, and combine and make a composite together. I also have tutorials on my website that teaches you how to do that step by step at Sturdevinci.com. And, you know, we have the sports composite video. It shows you how to do one image, how to make a composite, and then it shows you how to make multiple images. And what a lot of times we'll keep this on file, like this particular sports image that we have here, we may sell it again in a composite later in the year. Because once they get this stuff and then they see how much you're you're promoting the art and you're promoting their school, and then they decide to come do senior pictures with you. And I specialize in athletes, so I have more athletes come to me than anything else. And so I always keep this stuff on file, and I can use it later.
Okay, a question from Aaron. How do you offer your poster composite services during event coverage?
Well, we don't do event coverage. Like when I'm at an event shooting, we don't do that. We just, you know, we shoot it. We let them know. They know where to go online to see the images. And then when they go to the website, you know, they promote. It's hard to promote like when you're shooting a football game. And as far as, you know, if we do like events, like, well, let's say that we're shooting at the school, we will promote there and hand out literature there. But, you know, other than that, it's hard to promote at a football game or a basketball game. Nobody wants to get a flyer from you at that. They want to watch the game.
Okay, yeah, and question from Christina. She wants to know if you charge a session fee per team or per player.
No, per team.
Per team.
Yeah.
All right. Any last questions today? All right. Looks like that's going to be it for our Q&A session today. Thank you, everyone, for the great questions, and thank you so much, Richard, for taking the time to present today.
Well, thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
And thank you very much to everyone who joined us. As we mentioned earlier, our recording of today's webinar will be posted on the PhotoBiz YouTube channel at youtube.com/PhotoBiz. If you're interested in some of Richard's how-to videos, don't forget to check out Sturdevinci. That's where you can see all of what he's going to provide for you. Also, be sure to check out our blog and watch your email for updates about our future webinars. Last week, we went ahead and released our entire October schedule, so it's up there for you. You can register directly from that. And our next webinar is going to be Bizzing on a Budget, Free Design Resources, presented by Joanne Kay, who is a member of our marketing team.